The opinions and expressions and thoughts expressed here on the Fans POV are solely of the talent, aka myself. These opinions, thoughts, and expressions do not reflect those of Out of Time Productions, nor its employees, corporate sponsors, and or affiliates. So, viewer discretion is advised. Plus, also, don't take everything we say to heart. Trust me, most of the time we're kidding around. Unless it's something good, then you can take that to heart. Anywho, got that out of the way. This is the Fans POV KakoiCon 2008. The Fans POV. I am Ernie Liu coming to you from KakoiCon 2008 in Minneapolis, Minnesota. Now, where I am right now actually is in my hotel room at the Days Inn, which is right across from the Mall of America. So, if you ever want to come to the Mall of America, you know where to stay at. Anywho, I just need to clear a few things up that are on the. There was a YouTube comment on one of my mobile videos saying that Minnesota has two anime conventions, including this one, so that would be, there's another anime convention. I found out while I was interviewing people that there's another one called Anime Detour, which I think it's on hiatus right now, if I understand correctly. So, it used to be held at one of the hotels here, and KakoiCon just basically took over Anime Detour's thing. So, just, I guess there are two more, unless there's another one in some other part of Minnesota that I don't know about. That's the only one I know, so. Sorry about that. So, anywho, let's get going to KakoiCon. Overall, I thought the convention was actually pretty good. I liked it a lot. I've been to a lot of conventions, but they were mostly on the East Coast. This is the first time I've ever been to a Midwestern con. And I compare this convention to Anime Next in New Jersey, in Secaucus, it's a town called East Secaucus, New Jersey. It's where the New York Giants, Super Bowl champions, and New York Jets play. So it's around that vicinity. But Anime Next is sort of a small hometown type of feeling convention. And I think that KakoiCon actually has that same mutual feeling. As I was going around there, there were like a lot of people that knew everybody. And it was sort of like you were a family there because you just didn't know what to do. You just knew what to do. There was family there. You could do anything. And, you know, if somebody did something wrong or they were made fun of or they were, you know, if something happened, you know somebody's got your back there. So that's the best way I could describe KakoiCon. It was good, but however, there were some small things that I just didn't really – I didn't really like, and overall I think it was just the lack of panels or the lack of activity. It was really hard to find something to do there, because I see like a lot of people just walking around meeting people and all that stuff. There's usually a panel going on, and if the panel isn't going on, then there's really nothing else to do. So that was what my opinion on that was. So it's like, I think if they had more panels, I think if they had more activity, maybe some more dealers, because the dealers room, I'll get into that, I think it just sort of lacks some activity, but that's a first year convention, so I can't really say it's bad, but I think next year they should have some more panels, which I'm sure they're going to have. I'm not going to lie. I'm sure they're going to have that. So anywho, we're going to get into some of the activities here. The first one up is there was a Gothic Lolita tea party. Yes, a tea party for Gothic Lolitas. Unfortunately, what happened is that I wanted to get a piece of cake, and the people there told me that I couldn't, which I didn't like it because I wanted some cake, because I happen to like cake. I don't know about you all, but I like cake. And they told me no, and it kind of made me like, oh. I was like a little kid in the store. I was like, I want some cake. And it's just, you know, it couldn't go by the board. But actually, you know, the people who were running it were actually pretty cool. And we were able to get a short little interview with them. So here you go. Here's the ladies from the Gothic. Here's the some of the ladies from the Gothic Lolita Tea Party.
And I wanted to do a really big gathering at this convention because I know that a lot of Lolitas aren't really represented at a lot of the Midwest conventions. So I figured it would be a fun thing to do.
Okay, now how did you two jump on board? Because basically she came to you, or?
Well, I hang out with Sam a lot. We sew together, we design together, we just do whatever. So when she had the idea for this whole convention, and she had already just had thoughts and ideas in her head for a while, and when she mentioned doing the Lolita tea party, I thought it was an amazing idea, and I totally wanted to be a part of it. So.
And as for me, I've done a couple of fashion shows that have featured Samantha's designs, as well as other American Lolitas, and we've gotten to know each other through that, and I also interviewed Sam for the next volume of Gothic and Lolita Bible, and she invited me out here to be a guest, and I was thrilled to be able to participate.
If you want to see the full interview, I'll have the full interview up. I don't think I have time to put the full interview on here. But that was the Gothic, those were the people behind the Gothic Lolita Tea Party. Now, the next one up is obviously the Cafe More, or as if you want to put it in New York Anime Fest terms, the Maid Cafe. Now, this one, the Maid Cafe, Cafe More, it wasn't really like, I didn't get a chance to fully experience it because I just sat down just for some tea and just left afterwards because I wanted to get an interview. But it's a lot different than the one in New York Anime Festival. This one, I think they have drinks and they have food there, but you didn't have to pay for it, but they would graciously want a tip, as opposed to the New York Anime Festival where it was just maids escorting you to a table, and then you got up, you bought $5 hot dogs, and then you came back. So it's just, I don't know, maybe it's just in New York, who knows? But yeah, it was a good idea. I think it's good that they're starting to expand on that idea. Actually, here's a short interview with all the waitresses that were in Cafe Moe.
Oh, I'm Mei Tizuna.
Okay.
I'm Mei Marielle.
I'm Mei Akiko. Mei Claire.
Mei Juri.
Now, since you're here, you serve drinks. Now, is that like, do people have to pay for them, or is it offered? Was it offered?
Everything is free.
Okay.
It's nice to leave a tip, but everything is free.
Okay, now, why did you decide to do this?
Well, maid cafes are very popular in Japan right now, and so we decided that we wanted to have one as well.
So those are the girls from Cafe Moe. Of course, it's not the entire interview because we don't have time for it, but I will post up the entire interview sometime this week. Now, we're going to go on next to the Artist Alley and the Dealer's Room. Now, the Dealer's Room, I'll go there first, wasn't as big as I expected. It's basically, Dealer's Room was held like in a catering hall that a hotel has, except it wasn't that big. I think there were about, we'll say, at least 20 at most 25 dealers. So it's just not, it wasn't like stimulating enough for me. So I didn't go there often. I wanted to get something, and actually I did get something. So it just, I actually got this pin. This pin was just for you, Ray. And actually I really like this one. It's just, it describes a lot of a lot of my friends right now. So, but anywho, that so with the Dealer's Room, with that, and then with the Artist Alley, actually I got to meet a couple of them, and they were actually some pretty. There were some really talented artists there. So here you go. Here's the Artist Alley.
I'm Megan. I am here basically to sell my art and gain like some sort of fan base or something, which I don't have any of right now.
All right, well, my name is Marcus Allman. I'm the writer for an independent comic here called Razor Kid. And that's basically, I'm here selling copies of the first issue and prints of various posters. And what's that?
Okay, now.
My name is Becca, or I go by Muffin, as the sign shows. I'm trying to sell some fan art this year to make some money, I guess.
How about you?
I'm Anna, and I go by Athena Kitty. I don't know, this is my first con trying to sell at an Artist Alley, trying to make my spot.
I'm Lisa Gilbert. I'm Terry Blauer. We're here with the Black Hat Collective. We made this book.
Yeah.
Well, seven artists, yeah. Eight people. That's why the stuff in our booth doesn't match at all.
So those were all the artists that I was able to get at Artist Alley. Now we'll have a full segment featuring those guys later on this week. Just to remember, just to assure you of that. Now here you go with now we're gonna get into something that I really, really liked. It was the It was actually called the Random Panel. Now, it was okay. I'll explain it. It wasn't an official panel. It was not at all. It was just a bunch of people that went into a room. He stole the microphone and just started talking, trying to get people to come into the room. When I came in there, there was a good like 60 or 70 people in the room, and they were just doing anything. They did like "The Internet Is for Porn." They said "If I Was Gay." I have no idea what that song is either. So it was actually really, really funny. And at one point, they focused all the attention on me, which is not the greatest idea in the world. However, I thought it was pretty funny. So here you go. Here's some footage of the random panel along with two guys who actually organized it. Alright, here you go.
Okay, we're getting video coverage of the random panel right now, so if everybody can turn that way. I've got to explain this to you.
What?
This panel is not a legit panel. This is insane.
It actually started yesterday. A group of three people decided to do, I believe, a bleach panel. It was kind of boring, just decided out of the blue, found an empty room. So they started to do a random panel, at which point it snowballed. We had one person after another into the room, and by 4.5 hours later yesterday, we had a good 50 to 60 people in the room. At which point, we decided it'd be fun to do it again today. So we started out again today with about 4 people, and by the time it was all done, what would you say we had in there? About 70?
We did 4 hours, 2 days in a row.
That was 4 hours today?
It's 1 o'clock
already. Oh my goodness. 4 hours, 2 days in a row, and this is the only two panels I've been to so far.
And everybody agreed when I called the poll, is this not the best panel you've ever been to? Everybody was
the best panel.
That was the random panel right there. Those are the two guys who helped it. They had James and Jason. And they helped out with it. It was amazing. They had a four-hour panel for both Friday and Saturday. It's a just amazing thing. You know, if Out of Time ever does a panel, which we will do at one point, we will have a panel with Out of Time Productions. And it has to be completely as random as possible. We'll have some stuff there that are related to Out of Time, but after that, you can do it. We'll just do whatever. So, but anywho, the next thing up is the Power Power Con. Now, Power Power is a dance with the legs and the hands. I'm not sure how exactly, like, what the actual official explanation is, or a better way to explain it, because dancing with hands and legs, you know, that can mean anything. So I know John tried to explain it to me one time, and I just, in one ear, out the other. So it's just, that's the best way I could describe it from my point of view. I have no idea how exactly it goes, but that's how it is. So, but basically, they had a dance competition there, and there were three girls from Finland, and I thought I had a far travel from New York. Three people from Finland actually participated in the contest and won it. So, but trust me, I will have their interview on here as soon as possible. So now we get into the good part of it, the cosplayers from KokoiCon. There were actually a good amount, and I think the most I saw was Lolitas. There were a lot of Lolitas there, and I feel dirty just saying the word Lolita. Chris shouldn't, but anyhow, I'm just kidding, Chris, I'm kidding. The Lolita Fashions has gotten popular. When I first heard about it in December 2007 is when the first time I heard it. And ever since then, it's been growing. I've been seeing more and more Lolita fashion as I go. So it's just, it's crazy. That's the most I've seen there. But you know what? Here's a little compilation of all the cosplayers that I saw, including the ones I took pictures of on Friday.
Shake, 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 shake
All right, so those were all the cosplayers from both Saturday and Sunday. I'm not sure if I got everybody in there, but I'm going to try to fit everybody as much as possible. Now, finally, I guess I'll just give it a rating. I think for a first-time convention, it did really, really, really well. And I think that, as most people say, you know, they don't really give it too much of a high rating because of the first year. But however, I think it is really good for a first year. Like compare this to New York Anime Festival, which the first year had over 17,000 attend, where we only reached 10% of that here. And I think they did a really good job of just trying to stretch everything out, try to organize as much as they can, and just try to have it in a good location. So overall, I give it a 7. So it's a good convention. I think it needs a lot of help. Well, not too much help, but it needs a lot of growing. I guess that's the best way to describe it. It needs to flourish more, and it needs to, I think once it has more panels, once it gets more activity, once it has a following, then we could start saying, hey, it's up there with Anime Central, AX, or maybe Otakon, and all that great stuff. So overall, I give it a 7. But it's not up to me, you know, this is not my point of view, this is the fans' point of view, and I want to hear your comments. Scroll down to the bottom, if you're on YouTube, scroll down to the bottom and put your vote on there. Now we're going to go on to our next episode of the Fans POV, which will be next week. We'll be next week coming to you from Baltimore, Maryland for Otakon 2008. Now, basically, what it is that we're actually going to do, it'll be me and a friend of mine, Chrissy, who will be reporting on the different things. Well, we'll report on different experiences, on my experience, on her experience too. So we're gonna do a YouTube thing, report every day. It'll be Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. On Saturday's show, Saturday will be live. I'm hoping to get Friday live too. I can't promise you anything, but I would say check to the website down below. I don't know if any of you have Stickcam. You can check out our Stickcam account, which will be right below me, and hopefully we will be live. You can check back here for fan reports on KokoriCon plus also others, and I hope I didn't bore you to death. That's all I care. So, anywho, this is Ernie Liu with the Fans POV. Make sure you catch us next weekend for Otakon 2008, the biggest anime convention on the East Coast. All right, I am Ernie Liu, and I will see you guys later.
Leave your arm.